Cathie Wood, the CEO and CIO of ARK Invest, has been known for making outrageous price targets and then having those price targets actually turn out to be true. Most famously, she predicted that Tesla would reach $4,000 a share before the split in 5 years, when Tesla was in the low 200s.
You made a lot of waves by attaching a $4,000 price target to the shares at one point.
Cathie's next bold prediction is, as you likely saw by the title, Bitcoin to $500,000. Similar to Tesla, this seems like a totally outrageous price target. Yet, Cathie's moonshots always have lots of substance behind it, and that's why she's right so often. In this video, I'm gonna go over why Cathie Wood believes that Bitcoin will hit $500,000. Before we begin, please take a moment and subscribe to my second channel, Cass Gains Capital, if you haven't already. I'll be posting a lot more investing related content over there. If you enjoy my videos here, you'll also enjoy my content over there. Welcome to Cass Gains Academy. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing for more content like this, and let's get right into it. The unprecedented rates that the Federal Reserve is creating dollars at have led to many investors purchasing commodities like gold and silver in an attempt to hedge against inflation. However, in this day and age, investors are looking for alternatives to gold. This is where Bitcoin comes into play, which is essentially the digital standard to money, and more specifically, fiat currency. Fiat money, which consists of government-backed currencies that are not based on commodities like gold and silver, are highly susceptible to inflation. The US dollar is often seen as a standard for fiat money. All fiat money diminishes in value. Ever since the Federal Reserve was created in 1913, the US dollar has done nothing but go down. On the other hand, commodity money like gold and Bitcoin is not susceptible to these diminishing returns. Gold is a limited resource, as once all gold is mined, there won't be any more gold to look for. That is, unless if people start mining asteroids. Bitcoin serves as a digital version of gold, as there are only 21 million Bitcoin units and 18.5 million are already in existence. Yet, Bitcoin is much more than gold. In terms of efficiency, Bitcoin's transportation and storage are unrivaled by traditional commodities. With Bitcoin, you don't have to store it in a safe because you're afraid of it being stolen. With Bitcoin, you don't have to carry the heavy weight of gold around just to purchase materials. This is why Cathie believes in the long-term vision of Bitcoin.
Bitcoin is the reserve currency of the crypto asset ecosystem. It's the equivalent to the dollar in the fiat currency system. That's a pretty exalted role.
Bitcoin gets a horrible reputation from the media. Most of the time, we hear Bitcoin mentioned in scams on Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook. This isn't to say that Bitcoins are not used in scams. If you scroll down to the comment section, I'm sure you'll see a computer bot spamming their WhatsApp in the comments in an attempt to steal some Bitcoin from you. The reputation of Bitcoin as a tool used by scammers is a misconception. In fact, Bitcoin does the exact opposite of hiding money. By looking at someone's Bitcoin address, you can literally see where they sent Bitcoin to and where they received Bitcoin from. Most scammers do not get away with stealing Bitcoin. In fact, the hacker who hacked into famous Twitter accounts like Elon Musk, Bill Gates, and Joe Biden was caught stealing $120,000 and was promptly arrested. The media does not portray digital currency correctly, but Cathie Wood sees major potential in a separate education related to CBDCs. Knowing that Bitcoin is out of their control, countries have been exploring the creation of their own cryptocurrency. CBDCs, also known as central bank distributed currencies, are cryptocurrencies that are regulated by a country. The recent and eventually long-term rise in CBDCs will allow citizens to become more educated on what cryptocurrencies are like. Cathie Wood believes that the rise of CBDCs will enable people to learn more about cryptocurrencies, and more specifically, Bitcoin.
I also think that the CBDCs, which are the central bank distributed currencies that are digital currencies that we're beginning to hear a lot about around the world, including China, have led to sort of an education about what Bitcoin is. Bitcoin will not be controlled by any government. And in fact, with CBDCs, you're going to have a lot more surveillance over your purchasing behavior, what you do, when. So I have a feeling it may have awakened a, a bit of a giant here, because central banks and policymakers will not be able to do any surveillance on people per se. It's a pseudonymous. It's transparent, sure, but only by address, not by person. Whereas some of the CBDCs, especially in China, they'll enable the tracking of purchases and the tracking of activity at all times.
Over the past few months, large institutions are beginning to rethink their skepticism on Bitcoin. Most notably, PayPal has decided to launch a new service that allows users to buy, hold, and sell cryptocurrency. Additionally, the CEO of JPMorgan Chase has recently come out and said that Chase will always support blockchain technology following the official release of JPMorgan's own cryptocurrency named JPM Coin. Even Ray Dalio, one of the largest hedge fund managers, has admitted that he may be wrong about Bitcoin by stating, "I might be missing something about Bitcoin, so I'd love to be corrected." Cathie Wood believes that Bitcoin may be ready for institutions, and this could potentially push Bitcoin to $400 or even $500,000. After all, there is a limited supply of Bitcoin, and if institutions rush to buy Bitcoin, then the price would have no choice but to skyrocket.
And then the last thing that I think is going on is institutions are beginning to get interested in Bitcoin and crypto assets generally. And our analyst, Yasin Elmandra, just wrote two Bitcoin white papers on the notion is Bitcoin, are institutions ready for Bitcoin? Really, the opposite is true. Is Bitcoin ready for institutions? Bitcoin, the trading activity, is the equivalent of one or two mega cap stocks in the stock market. So it's still quite small relative to the stock market and certainly relative to the bond market. But we do see institutions starting to nibble. And I liken this to the early days of institutions moving into real estate and emerging markets. They started out with 0.5% allocation, then 1%, and then 5% or thereabouts seemed to be the right number. If the same thing were to happen to Bitcoin, given the supply is going to top out at 21 million units, if we were to see that mid-single digit allocation to Bitcoin on the part of institutions, and this would be all institutions, so this is not going to happen, but just to dimension what could happen, well, Bitcoin is closing in on 20,000 right now. But if institutions were to go to that mid-single digit territory in terms of allocation to Bitcoin alone, that would take it to somewhere in the $400,000 to $500,000 range. So 20,000 to 400,000.
The final question we must ask is whether Bitcoin is still a buy today. Bitcoin has rallied substantially since the PayPal crypto announcement and is, at the time of recording this video, approaching $20,000. Cathie Wood believes that the answer to this question is yes. If we're thinking long term, Bitcoin still has a lot of potential for institutions and governments to buy in as a hedge against fiat currency. We're currently at that inflection point where these large institutions will want to buy into Bitcoin, but there is a limited supply of Bitcoin.
Let's talk about Bitcoin for a moment. I think while everyone was focused on the big tech stocks, Bitcoin suddenly rallied from about 5,400 to nearly 18,000. That was quite a shock to discover. Do you think it's a buy now? And what would you say is the bull case for Bitcoin?
Well, we believe it has a very long way to run. And yes, we're approaching the last peak, which was nearly $20,000 in 2017. And since then, our confidence has grown.
Let me know what you think about Cathie Wood's price target for Bitcoin. Do you think Bitcoin will hit $500,000? Or do you think that Bitcoin will be shut down by governments? If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next one.